Jessie Tarbox Beals, when she had been a very young woman, had saved up whatever coupon she was collecting, and she'd bought herself a very inexpensive camera.
And when she grew up, she became the first female photographer hired by a U.S. newspaper. Jessie Tarbox Beals had a long and varied career, but in St. Louis, she is best remembered for her classic photographs of the 1904 Olympics and World's Fair.
She had a very difficult time getting a press pass for the Louisiana Purchase Exposition because she was a woman, but she was, if anything, persistent. And finally, she got a pass to go in and photograph the exposition while it was still under construction.
Beals would never become one of the fair's official photographers, but the images she recorded at the fair remain some of the most abiding of the fair.
She took stunning images of people, tribes from the Philippines and tribes from the United States and other native peoples from around the world who were actually put on exhibit in the fair. Jessie looked at these people through her camera lens with a very sympathetic eye. You know, we all here have a St. Louis-centric view of the world, and so I think from our perspective, her work at the 1904 World's Fair was the pinnacle of her achievement. She might have agreed, although she led a long and productive life aside from the World's Fair.
After the fair, Jessie Tarbox Beals moved to New York City, divorced her husband, who had done all of her photo developing, and opened her own studio where she made portraits of some very famous people, including Mark Twain and Teddy Roosevelt, whom she had first photographed during his visit to the 1904 World's Fair.